ग्रेविटेशन स्टैंडर्ड 10th साइंस 1 ग्रेविटेशन सो दिस विल बी पार्ट 3 आई थिंक ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन आई विल नॉट पुट पार्ट नंबर हियर लेटर ऑन आई विल गिव दैट नेम टू दिस वीडियो नाउ टुडे आई एम नॉट यूजिंग कीपिंग टेक्स्ट बुक ओपन बट इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ टेक्स्ट बुक आई विल बी स्पीकिंग एंड प्रेजेंटिंग अ फ्यू फैक्ट्स विच वन शुड अंडरस्टैंड तर मुलांनो मराठी आणि इंग्लिश दोन्हीमधून मला बोलावं लागणार आहे कारण मी हा व्हिडिओ करतो आहे तो फक्त इंग्रजी समजणाऱ्या मुलांसाठी नव्हे तर पालकांच्या हौसेखातर अनेक मराठी कुटुंबांमधली मुलं ही इंग्लिश मिडियमच्या शाळेत जातात किंवा सेमी इंग्लिश घेतात आणि त्यांना इंग्लिश अजिबात समजत नसतं अशा मुलांसाठी मी हा व्हिडिओ करतो आहे प्रामुख्याने सो आय विल बी स्पीकिंग bilingual in English as well as in Marathi. So, first I will like to revise a concept in mathematics that is called variation. What is that? Suppose there are some laddus in a container. There are some laddus. We don't know the number of laddus here. But what is given in the question is, if 5 are eaten per day. एका दिवशी पाच लाडू खाल्ले then it will be sufficient then it will be enough the stock will be enough for 12 days and now the question is that if 4 are eaten per day then how many days the stock will be enough for That is the question. जर तुम्ही एका दिवशी पाच लाडू खाल्ले तर 12 दिवस पुरतील पण ते पाच ऐवजी 4 खाल्ले तर किती दिवस पुरतील तो स्टॉक किती दिवसासाठी पुरेल असा प्रश्न आहे आणि हा प्रश्न जो आहे खूपच सोपा आहे तर याच्यामध्ये आपण काय करतो दोन क्वांटिटीज आहेत त्या मांडून घेतो विचार द टू क्वांटिटीज या क्वांटिटी वन क्वांटिटी वन इज नंबर ऑफ लड्डूज पर डे लेट अस कॉल दिस एक्स देन क्वांटिटी टू इज नंबर ऑफ डेज फॉर विच द स्टॉक इज इनफ. दिस इज क्वांटिटी नंबर टू. लेट अस कॉल दिस वाई. नाउ if you observe carefully, as x increases, y should logically decrease. Means if you eat more laddus per day, then obviously number of days will become less. So more x implies less y. Less x, if you eat less laddus per day, then it will be enough for more days. So more y. So this type of variation is called inverse variation. So here we write y is inversely proportional as x. So that was about inverse variation. And if in some particular problem there is direct variation, means what? If x is more, then y will also be more. If x is less, y will also be less. Then in such case, that is direct variation. Let us take a problem on direct variation. So now I will not write the problem. You can write down if you want. 12 notebooks, cost ₹144. So what is the cost of 7 notebooks? So obviously here are again two quantities. Quantity 1 is x is number of notebooks. And quantity 2 is y. What is that? Cost of notebooks. So obviously if you purchase more number of notebooks, so more x implies more y. Less x implies less y. That is common sense. So more x implies more y. Less x implies less y. And this is called direct variation. And we write the statement of direct variation as y directly varies as x. So this has something to do with gravitation. That is why I have revised this mathematical concepts, direct variation and inverse variation. So there is also something called as constant of proportionality or constant of variation, that we will come to this concept in the meantime. So there are two objects according to Newton's law of gravitation. Every object pulls the other object. So there is a force F with which this object is pulled towards that object. And there is a force equal and opposite, so we will call it minus F. This object is pulled by this object. So both are equal and opposite forces. So it's a pair of forces between two objects. And both the objects are pulling each other. It's a force of attraction only. No repulsion is seen in gravitation. So let us say this object has mass m1 and this object has mass m2. So, Newton's law of gravitation states, Newton's law of gravitation, what does it say? It says that this force F is directly proportional to mass of one object. This force F is also directly proportional to mass of other object. And if these two objects are separated by distance r, then this F is inversely proportional to square of distance between them. So these are the three variations according to which this force of attraction, the strength of this force of attraction, is decided. So let us think, how did Newton find out this fact? It's a very long story. I want to tell it, but I'll request you to email me that you need to hear that story, how Newton thought of mathematics of this kind. So it's not merely the story of falling apple, it is something beyond that. Story of falling apple just started the thing. But here, Newton speaks about mathematics of gravitation. And these three variations Newton proposes. Now it is easy to understand these variations if you and me also think slightly more. So sun pulls the earth and also the earth pulls the sun. Earth pulls the sun, it is difficult to digest, no? Because sun is stationary, we say. Then how do we say that earth pulls the sun? But you see, mass of sun is the thing which is playing role. Suppose here we have this m1 and this m1 mass is say 10,000 times of this mass m2. Then whatever this force is there, then force upon mass is acceleration. So acceleration of m1 will be very less, practically zero. So apparently we will see that m1 does not move at all and m2 only moves. सो ॲपल फॉल्स ऑन अर्थ, बट डू यू नो वन थिंग, ॲपल ऑल्सो इज पुलिंग द अर्थ, बट कंपेयर द मासेस, ॲपल मास ऑफ ॲपल इज एक्स्ट्रीमली लेस ॲज कम्पेअर्ड टू मास ऑफ अर्थ. सो व्हॉट एवर फोर्स एफ विल बी जनरेटेड, एफ फोर्स ऑफ ग्रॅव्हिटेशन, ऑब्विसली ॲक्सिलरेशन ऑफ ड्यू टू ग्रॅव्हिटी विल बी व्हेरी लेस फॉर अर्थ अँड मच मोअर फॉर ॲपल. And this distance also is inversely proportional to r square. This force, all force is inversely proportional to r square. What does that mean? That means this force is more if distance is less. So if distance is 2 units and force is say 40 units, then 40 force is for 2 units distance. If this distance becomes from 2 units to 3 units, then what will happen to the force? So 40 into 4, 160 upon 3 square 9. So 160 is equal to F into 9. So 160. So if we say F is equal to, let us consider this inverse variation case, F is equal to 2 Newton, F is equal to 40 Newton and R is equal to say 2 meters. I am just taking hypothetical values. These values need not be there in real life situation. So, what will be the force if R becomes 3 meters, keeping the body's constant obviously? So there is no change in M1 and M2. We need not consider that. So for inverse variation, product of these two is constant. You can go back in the video and see that example of laddus. 5 laddus are sufficient for 12 days. 4 laddus, how many days? So 5 into 12 is 60. 4 into how much? That is 15. So 15 days is the answer. So for inverse variation, the product of these two is equal. So what is, so if here we say that it is x newtons, then product will be x into r square is 9 is equal to 40 into r square is 4. And so x will be 160 by 9, that is 9 1 9 7 remaining 7 0 70 9 7 the 63 plus 7 70, so 7 7 7 7, so 7 bar. So when distance changes by 1 meter only, the force is reduced drastically because it is inversely proportional to the square of the distance. So from 40 newtons, force comes down to 17.7 newtons. If you round up, it will be 17.8 newtons, suppose. So this is the mathematics of gravitational acceleration. Inverse square law, it is often said that the force is inversely proportional to the square of distance. That is inverse square law. Now, with this much set of variations, So there are three variations, direct, two direct variations and one inverse variation. Then whatever given it in the textbook, you will understand combined formula and all. We will be speaking more on that in the next part of the video. Till then, keep reading, keep thinking, keep solving. Best wishes.